We are going to discuss some graded problems in friction today. Here we have a simple problem on the board. A block of mass M is kept on rough horizontal surface having coefficient of friction mu. The block is to be pulled by applying a force on it. Calculate the minimum force and its direction. A simple problem. Let's start. Imagine this is the rough horizontal surface on which we have kept a mass M. They are saying this mass is to be pulled by application of a force, and then they want you to calculate what will be the minimum magnitude of the force and in which direction it should be acting. Let's say this. I'll assume let the force is P or F and it is acting at angle alpha with horizontal. That means I have to calculate the minimum magnitude of F and the angle alpha for which F will be minimum, right? So let's see the FBD, free body diagram, weight is down mg, normal axis R is up, and if I try to pull it to the right, then force of friction Fr is acting to the left. Clear? If you resolve the force, the horizontal component is F cos theta, alpha cos alpha, and vertical is F sine alpha. Clear? Now imagine a situation, the force is to be minimum, means the block is on the verge of moving and all the forces are in what? Equilibrium. So I'll say let force is F at angle alpha. Clear? Now, as I try to pull it to the right, then force of friction mu r is going to act to the what? Left. Okay? Now I'll be considering the equilibrium of vertical forces, and I'll also consider the equilibrium of the horizontal forces. So I'll say, consider equilibrium of vertical forces. If you consider the equilibrium of vertical forces, you can see two forces are up, R and F sin theta, and one force is down. So we have R plus F sin alpha is equal to how much M? Mg. So from here we get R equals to Mg minus F sin alpha. This is equation 1. I got the value of normal reaction R. Now, if you consider equilibrium of horizontal forces, you can see there are only two forces. One is F cos alpha and the other is Fr. They must cancel each other. So, I'll say for equilibrium of horizontal forces, if I consider horizontal forces, then F cos alpha is equal to Fr, and Fr is how much? Mu r. And children, we already have the value of R, Mg minus F sin alpha. If I put this value, then I get F cos alpha equals to mu into Mg minus F sin alpha, or F cos alpha equals to mu Mg minus mu into F sin alpha. Now bring mu on the left hand side, then F cos alpha plus mu F sin alpha is equal to mu into Mg. Take F common, cos alpha plus mu sin alpha is equal to mu Mg, right? So from here we get F is equal to mu Mg divided by cos alpha plus mu sin alpha. Technically speaking, children, this is the value of F. But the question is asking the minimum value of F. I cannot change mu Mg, is already given. For minimizing the value of F, you can see the denominator should be maximum. Denominator should be what? Maximum. And for making this maximum, I have to use the condition for maxima and minima. Okay? So for F minimum, डेरिवेटिव ऑफ कॉस अल्फा प्लस म्यू साइन अल्फा विद रिस्पेक्ट टू अल्फा शुड इक्वल टू हाउ मच, जीरो. ओके, फॉर मैक्सिमम मिनिमा द डेरिवेटिव शुड इक्वल टू हाउ मच, जीरो. डेरिवेटिव कॉस अल्फा इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच है, माइनस साइन अल्फा. म्यू डेरिवेटिव ऑफ साइन अल्फा इज कॉस अल्फा इज इक्वल टू जीरो, सो साइन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू हाउ मच है, म्यू कॉस अल्फा. टेन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू म्यू और अल्फा इज इक्वल टू टेन इनवर्स म्यू. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट इफ आई वॉन्ट द फोर्स टू बी मिनिमम देन टेन अल्फा शुड बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच है, म्यू, राइट. और अल्फा शुड बी इक्वल टू टेन इनवर्स ऑफ म्यू. वंस आई नो अल्फा और टेन अल्फा देन आई कैन कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस अल्फा एंड साइन अल्फा. इन ट्रिग्नोमेट्री अदरवाइज ऑल्सो यू हैव डन दैट मैक्सिमम वैल्यू ऑफ ए साइन अल्फा प्लस बी कॉस अल्फा. इन ट्रिग्नोमेट्री हैव डन ना मैक्सिमम वैल्यू हाउ मच है, ए स्क्वायर प्लस बी स्क्वायर. सो दिस पार्ट वी कैन डू डायरेक्टली ऑल्सो, बट वी हैविंग टू डिफरेंशिएट बिकॉज दे आस्किंग फॉर द एंगल. इफ आई पुट द वैल्यू ऑफ टेन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू म्यू हियर, इफ आई पुट टेन अल्फा इज इक्वल टू म्यू, दिस इज म्यू एन वन, दिस इज रूट वन प्लस म्यू स्क्वायर, राइट. सो यू कैन इजिली कैलकुलेट द वैल्यू ऑफ कॉस अल्फा एंड साइन अल्फा. सो देयरफॉर एफ इज इक्वल टू म्यू एम जी डिवाइडेड बाई कॉस अल्फा. इफ यू लुक एट द डायग्राम, कॉस अल्फा इज हाउ मच है, रूट ओवर वन अपॉन वन प्लस म्यू स्क्वायर प्लस म्यू. साइन अल्फा इज म्यू डिवाइडेड बाय रूट ओवर वन प्लस म्यू स्क्वायर. सो चिल्ड्रन इट बिकम्स म्यू एम जी डिवाइडेड बाय वन प्लस म्यू स्क्वायर डिवाइडेड बाय रूट ओवर वन प्लस म्यू स्क्वायर. एंड इफ यू सिंप्लीफाई देन द मिनिमम वैल्यू ऑफ फोर्स बिकम्स म्यू एम जी डिवाइडेड बाय रूट ओवर वन प्लस म्यू स्क्वायर. सो वी गॉट बोथ आंसर्स. द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ मिनिमम फोर्स इज म्यू एम जी डिवाइडेड बाय रूट ओवर वन प्लस म्यू स्क्वायर एंड टेन अल्फा विल बी इक्वल टू म्यू और अल्फा विल बी टेन इनवर्स ऑफ म्यू. ओके, ऑलराइट चिल्ड्रन, हियर वी हैव अनदर प्रॉब्लम. द कोएफिशिएंट ऑफ फ्रिक्शन बिटवीन द बोर्ड एंड द फ्लोर इज म्यू. फाइंड द मैक्सिमम फोर्स दैट द मैन कैन एक्सर्ट ऑन द ropes so that the board does not slip. Let's see this problem. There's a man here, mass of the man is capital M. He is standing on a board whose mass is small m. And then you can see he is pulling the free end of the rope. This is the rope. One end of the rope is connected to the board having mass small m. And then passes over this network of pulleys and the free end is pulling like this. And they are saying that what force should he apply so the board does not slip. Meaning, the tension that he will produce by pulling the free end of the rope should not exceed the friction between the block having mass small m and the flow, right? So let's see. Let's see, he is applying a force F and this force F will produce a tension T. So we can assume that he produces a tension T. Now the same tension he will pull it forward. Clear? Now, the floor will be applying a certain force on him. Let's say the force applied by the normal reaction of the floor, the block on the man is R1. Let's say this is R1. Right? If I draw a BD of this man, this is the man, here is the man. Now this is the man actually. So normal reaction of the man will be how much here? R1. This normal reaction is how much? R1. Right? You can see that as he pulls the rope, the tension is pulling upwards. The tension is where? Upwards. And his weight mg is acting downwards. You can see only these many forces acting on him. There are two forces upwards. And his weight is where? Downwards. He is standing on this board. This is the board on which is standing. Right? So, considering forces on the man, upward force is R1 plus T is called capital Mg. So from here you can calculate R1, that is Mg minus T. This is equation 1. Very easy. And I'm assuming let force applied by the man on the rope is equal to T. Clear? Now it becomes a very interesting problem. When I'll study FBD of the block, let's see children, FBD of the block. This is the block. The block is resting on the floor, right? Its weight Mg, first things first, will be acting downwards. Clear? Now, this block is applying a force, normal action force R1 upwards. So don't forget that this man is pushing this block downwards with what force? R1. Clear? Now this is very crucial for you to understand. R1 is acting downwards. Now reaction of the floor, this floor, on the block will be where? Upwards. So let's say this is R2. Now the conceptual thing to understand it, that R1 will be the force applied by the man on the block will be acting downwards, right? R1 is downwards and R2 is reaction of the floor on the block, that is upwards. And then here you can very easily see, tension T is pulling this block forward and force of friction is acting where? Backwards, right? So we'll say here, for vertical equilibrium, vertical equilibrium of the block. When I look at the block children, clearly you can see there are two forces above. One is directed up, the other is directed down, and Mg directed again down. So we have R2 equals to R1 plus Mg. And you already know how much is R1? Mg minus T. So R2 is equal to how much? Mg minus T plus small mg. So you got R2 also. For equilibrium of vertical forces acting on the block. Now I'll be considering equilibrium of horizontal forces. In horizontal direction, the two forces, one is T, the other is Fr. So I'll say for equilibrium of horizontal forces, if I consider equilibrium of horizontal forces, then you can see T is acting in the forward direction and Fr is acting in the backward direction, then T will be equal to Fr. And Fr is how much children? Mu R2. I already know the value of R2. This is the value of R2. Whenever you deal with these problems, you must be very clear about which forces acting in which direction, because these all are contact forces. So I'll just put the value of R2 here. T is equal to mu R2. Let's put it children. Then what do you get? T equals to mu. R2 is Mg minus T plus small mg. Mg minus T plus small mg. Clear? So once I put this value, I simplify T is equal to mu Mg minus mu T plus mu small mg. Bring T on this left hand side. T plus mu into T is equal to mu take common, G take common, capital M plus small m. So T is how much children? Mu G into capital M plus small m divided by 1 plus. Right, so we very easily calculated what is the minimum force that he has to apply What is the force that he has to apply to remain in equilibrium? And that is mu g into capital M plus small m divided by 1 plus mu. Right? Okay. We'll move on to the next sum now, children. Make sure you're understanding it. Okay, children. Let's understand this. Here we have been given, find the acceleration a1, a2, a3 of the three blocks as shown in figure. If a 10 newton horizontal force is applied, this force is first applied on, here we can see a system of three blocks piled on top of each other. We have 7 kilogram, coefficient of friction is 0. Then we have 3 kilogram, coefficient of friction is 0.3. And then here we have 2 kilogram, coefficient of friction 0.1. And then acceleration of 2 kilogram is A1, 3 kilogram is A2, and 7 kilogram is A3. Now there are three situations. Case 1, when this 10 kilogram block is applied to 2 kilogram mass, it's a very conceptual problem and I wanted to understand this and interact with the problem. Here we have case 1. Case 1. See here, this is 2 kilogram block. 2 kilogram block. Now it is resting on 3 kilogram block, and here we have 7 kilogram block. Clear? Now here I am applying 10 newton force. Let's understand it very nicely. When I apply a 10 newton force in the forward direction, then force of friction on this will act as what? I'll call it FR1. It'll act in which direction? Backward direction. Right? Now, in this case, weight 2g is going to act downwards and normally R1 is going to act where? Upwards. Clear? So first things first, we'll calculate here. R1 is equal to 2g, 2 into 10 is equal to 20 newton. 20 newton is normally action on the uppermost block. Now let's see here, you're pulling forward with a force of 10 newton and a backward force is what? FR1, force of friction. Then net force on 2 kg block. Try to understand it very nicely. Net force on 2 kilogram block will be F is equal to 10 minus FR. 10 minus FR is mu R1. So F is equal to 10 minus, how much is mu there? Mu 0.2, yes? So 0.2 into 20. So we have F is equal to 10 minus 4, 6 newton. Therefore acceleration A1 will be F by M, and that is 6 divided by 2, 3 meter per second square. It is clear. Once again we'll go through this. I'm applying a 10 newton force, very easy problem. Normal action is R1. Then the only opposing force will be FR1. So FR1 we calculated here. R1 we calculated is 20 newton. F is equal to 10 minus FR, 10 minus mu R1. We put all of mu, R1 you already know is 20. So we have 4, right? 6 newton. So acceleration A1 of the first block will be 3 meter per second square. Now, the other part of the problem becomes very interesting. Let's see. What happens to this block and this block? If you study, let's see, this is 3 kilogram block. Right? Force of friction on the upper block is to the left. So FR1 on the lower block will be way to the right. When this FR1 will try to pull, remember there's already a block here, 2 kilogram block. FR1 on the lower block will be in the which direction? Forward. Because friction is like this, no? If on one surface it is back, then the other surface it is front, right? Okay. FR1 is in the forward direction. But you see, the 7 kilogram block which has been kept here below is having a coefficient of friction out here. Mu 2 is how much? 0.3. So force of friction out here will be in the which direction? Backward direction, right? And the normal reaction on 3 kilogram block here is R2, right? And R2 will be equal to how much R? 2 plus 3, 5G. That very important concept that you have to learn here is that normally at this point how much weight is acting downwards? 5 kilogram weight. 2 plus 3, that is 5. Okay? So R2 is equal to how much of children? R2 is equal to 5G. 5 into 10, 50 Newton. Now here comes the most interesting part. Let's look at the 3 kilogram block. If you look at a 3 kilogram block, then force of friction FR2 will be mu2 R2, mu2 is 0.3 into 50 Newton. So, on 3 kilogram block, there are two forces acting. Let's discuss this. I'll separately draw this once again. 3 kilogram block, FR1 is acting in the forward direction. And how much FR1, children? FR1 you already calculated, no? FR1 is 4. This is FR1. This is 4 Newton. And FR2 is 50 Newton. So you are trying to pull it forward. That one said. You are trying to pull it forward into how much force? 4 Newton. But opposing force is how much? 15 Newton. That means if I am standing here, you are trying to pull it forward with 4 Newton force and there is a force opposing 15 Newton. I won't be able to move in the forward direction because opposing force is greater. That means this 3 kilogram block is not going to move. So I'll say, since FR2 is more than FR1, therefore 3 kg block does not move. So if 3 kilogram block will not move, that means this 3 kilogram and 7 kilogram, they will actually be moving together as a single unit. Together as a single unit. Right? So, let's understand like this. This is 3 kilogram block and this is 7 kilogram block. So, combined weight here is 10 and the pulling force here is how much you have? FR1, that is 4 Newton. So since these two blocks will not be able to get separated, then these two will be accelerated in the forward direction by what force? 4 Newton force. Means 3 kilogram or 7 kilogram will move as a unified mass. So 3 kg and 7 kg move as a single block. Single block. So that means if they move as a single block, they both will be having what? A combined mass of 10 kilogram and their accelerations will be equal. So A2 will be equal to A3 and that will be F by 10, 4 by 10. So that is 0.4 meter per second square. I hope you understood the first concept when the force is applied to 2 kilogram block. Alright children, now we will be discussing case 2 of this. Case 2 now. When 10 Newton force is applied to 3 kilogram block. Now it will be easy for you to understand here. The situation is something like this. This is 2 kilogram block. This is 3 kilogram block and this is 7 kilogram block. And here I am applying force F is equal to 10 Newton. Now, if I apply a force of 10 Newton out here, we already know that this force of friction is FR1 and this force of friction is how much F? FR2. Clear? So remember, if I apply a force on this is 2, this is 3 and this is 7, if I apply a force of 10 Newton on the middle block, that is 3 kilogram block, it will be able to move, it will be able to have a relative motion with respect to 2 kilogram block and 7 kilogram block, if and only if FR1 plus FR2 is less than what? 10 Newton force. See, imagine I'm trying to pull this piece of chalk in the forward direction. There's friction here and there's friction here. I'm applying a force of 10 Newton. Very easy. 10 Newton in this direction. I want to move to my right. And here I have a force FR1 and here I have a force what? FR2. So FR1 and FR2, they both are opposing my force 10 Newton. Now if FR1 plus FR2 is more than 10 Newton, I won't be able to move the chalk. See, I'm not able to move. And now if I apply more, I'll be able to move. So the question is, how much minimum force I need for moving See here, case 2, when 10 Newton force is applied to 3 kg block. If I apply to 3 kg block, children, so what will be the total force of friction acting on 3 kg block? We know FR1 is how much? 4 Newton. We derived earlier, NFR2 is equal to how much? 15 Newton, right? So total force of friction acting upon 3 kg mass. How much is the total force of friction acting on 3 kg mass? FR will be equal to FR1 plus FR2. So that is 4 plus 15, 19 Newton. So imagine a situation in which I am pulling with a force of 10 Newton and this opposing force is how much? 19 Newton. Opposing force is more, so obviously this force will not be able to produce any motion in 3 kilogram block. Right? That means if 3 kilogram is not able to move with relative to 2 and 7 kilogram block, this whole thing will become like a single unified block. It will become like a single unified block. Right? It becomes something like this. Right? Therefore, I conclude, hence 3 kg block has no relative motion. Has no relative motion. Will have no relative motion with respect to 7 kilogram or 2 kilogram block, and therefore they'll move as unified mass. It'll become something like this. They'll become something like this. Right? And combined mass will be how much? 5 plus 7, 12 kilogram. Therefore, they will all move with common acceleration. Therefore, A1 is equal to A2 is equal to A3. And the pulling force will be 10. 10 by mass is how much you have? 12. So 5 by 6 meter per second square. Okay, children. So this is a very easy problem that we discussed. Right? But you have to know whether the blocks will be able to have the relative motion or not. Okay? Now we'll move on to the next problem. Okay, children. We'll go for case 3. Case 3 we can see here only. This is 7 kilogram mass. This is 7 kilogram block. We know that this surface is smooth. This surface is smooth. μ3 is equal to 0. And here I am applying 10 Newton force. But when I apply 10 Newton force here, immediately above there is an opposing force of friction FR2. That's how much? 15 Newton. And then we have another 3 kilogram block here and 2 kilogram block here. That means in this case also, when I am trying to pull 7 kilogram block forward with the force of 10 Newton, there will be no relative motion because opposing force is more than 10 Newton. Okay? So case 3, here we have case 3, FR is more than 10 Newton. Why? Because FR2 is how much? 15 Newton is more than 10 Newton. Therefore, 7 kilogram block has no relative motion. No relative motion. And if there is no relative motion, then again all the three blocks will move together as one unit. I'll not be able to dislodge 7 kilogram block. It will remain as it is, and 3 and 2 kilogram blocks will be remaining as unified block. So here also, A1 is equal to A2 is equal to A3 is equal to how much? F by M. So we have 10 by 12, that is 5 by 6 meter per second square. Alright, children, so we did all the three parts of this beautiful problem. I hope you understood.